You know what, with Birdie, yeah? Let me pause it for a second. With Birdie, yeah? Actually, what I'm going to do, I'm going to start off with just these normals. And, oh, you want me to look over one of your matches, yeah? Alright, that's cool. Yeah, just send it, tweet it to me, innit? Tweet it to me. And I'll do like a match analysis or something like that. Tweet it to me. I'll probably do a match analysis and just throw it up on my YouTube. Just to help you out and stuff. Alright, so there's 15 people in the stream. Welcome everyone to the stream. I appreciate every single one of you lot being in the stream. Today I'm going to be doing a Birdie breakdown. So with the Birdie breakdown, it's pretty much covering his normals, his throws, what to do in V-trigger, and that is it. What I'm planning on doing every Monday is doing, like, let's say just a breakdown, just to help Birdie players just kind of mentally prepare for matches and stuff, because obviously, as you've been seeing in tournaments, Birdie doesn't really play top 8. Birdie's kind of like a character that is easy to use but hard to win with. So I'm just going to give you guys my breakdown of what I would do in certain situations and stuff like that. And then the following week, this is going to happen every Monday. So what I'm going to do as well is I'm going to do certain things where it's like teaching you guys what you do in certain matchups. So maybe next week I might do something to do with Karen and just kind of like show you certain things that I would do in a matchup with Karen, what I would do if my back's against the wall and certain things like that. Other Birdie players that might be better than me might do certain things their way, but this is the way how I'll do things. So it's up to you guys if you guys want to listen and learn. So yeah, that's it really. But today I'm going to start off with like Birdie's normals and stuff. Yeah, we'll take it from there actually. Alright, cool. So let me stop this action and I'll show you something. Alright, so start again. Alright, so Birdie's normals. As you guys know, he's got light kick, which is 4 frames, and his jab is 5 frames. So when most characters have like 3 frame or 4 frame jab. Birdie's big, slow, 4 frame and his light kick, which is good, but he's hitbox. Like, you don't have to block this, you can stand up and block this. So I'll just demonstrate it with Karen quickly so you guys know. Alright, stand, block. Just put a steel guard over. See? So it's considered, I'd say, mid. But then again, a mid is a high, you can stand and block it. But it's quite quick. You could do certain things like grab. You know what I mean? Just certain little things like that. Just keep pressure. Or overhead. Or just keep pressure. From a certain distance. Alright, cool. So light kick, light punch, which is good. You know, if there's moves like that are punishable, so say for example, if there's like a 4 frame, if a move is -4, you can get it off a guard crush. I mean guard break, not guard break. Yeah, let me get it off guard. Sorry. So if he does light kick, you could do light boom. So it's like a -4. That you've got to deal with. You can confirm the light kick is okay. I don't know why it's not working. You could also do it into EX, like, and then V-trigger. But I don't wanna complicate people's minds, so I'm gonna break it down to you in thank you very much, Spawn of Odd, for the host. I appreciate it, bro. Thank you very much. I'm just going to tell you guys, I'm not going to go complicated with you, I'm just going to show you the moves. And then I'll later show you setups and certain things like that. Alright, so light kick, light punch, medium punch, medium kick. Medium kick is really good for like, just for pressure. So say for example, if you want to get in and it's hard to get in someone, medium kick is useful, medium kick is good. Same with medium punch is good as well for catching out whiffs. Hard punch is really good for like distance. So say for example, if you've got someone in the corner, distance in. Standing hard can be really good as well because you're not minus at all. Minus, let me see. Let me just double check on this. I'm more than sure. If he is minus, it's not something that's punishable. So let me go into my V-Frames app. Shout out to V-Frames. Well, V-Frames is an app that you guys need. So if you guys need to learn like your character and stuff and frames and stuff, and you're not really frame heavy, like myself, I don't really know every single frame of Birdie. So I have to occasionally look on the app. So standing hard kick is on block is zero.
Yeah.
So standing hard punch, I want to see what standing hard punch. Standing hard punch is minus six. Okay, so I would never do standing hard punch from here because it's minus six and I'll get punished. Yeah? So the best thing to do with that is to do it from a distance because it's hard to punish. See what I'm saying? And it's got pushback as well. So as you can see, I'll start off here and I'll get pushed back. The reason why I say do standing hard punch from distance is because it gets people scared. They don't want to move. Well, you could, like, Birdie has one of the best anti-airs in the game. So you always do standing hard punch from distance. I'll always do standing hard punch from there. I'll never do standing hard punch deep. What's the point? You're going to get punished. Yeah, he's got pushback, but you're going to get punished. Okay, so we've got the normals out of the way. Now we're going to go for the unique moves. So the unique moves are Birdie has forward hard punch, which he has armor, which does it. What does it start on? The armor frames is three, between 3 and 15 frames. So that's cool. Down forward hard punch, airborne frames is 11 to 14 frames. Upper body projectile invincible frames is 15 to 36 frames. So what that means is when I do this, when I'm airborne for 11 to 14 frames, so anything that's low, like say for example, Nakali's ground pound, if you put 11 to 14 frames, that will miss. And what it means by projectile invisible frames, 15. So I'd say, I think from when he starts to slide down, the projectile will go over it. You have to time it. It's not a thing that is easy, and you have to time it. So what you gotta do is you gotta kind of like know what you're doing. That's all I gotta say. I know it sounds stupid and it's cliche, but you have to know what you're doing. So I never really throw this out unless it's for me, but I'm gonna explain what meaty is later on down the line. Okay, so we've gone through that. Overhead is minus four from what I believe. I need to double check it. It's minus four. I think it's minus four. Alright, so forward hard kick is minus four. Second hit is an overhead. So this move is really good, and the distance hit is really good, so I could probably get overhead from there. See, look at the distance. Now people say skank, it is, it's quite bad. So crouch, so I want to try and scare someone, so I'll be like, not even that, just, people don't expect it as well because it comes out so rapid as well. So like you could probably do, you know what I mean, so mix it up with jumping medium punch, light kick, and then overhead. Because people think, oh, okay, you're going to grab. Because you can either mix it up, you can mix it up with like, when you do overhead, I mean the jumping medium punch, you can mix it up with command grab. And that's what people get scared of, when people want to jump. So instead of doing that, you just do that, and it works. Majority of the time. And because of the distance of the light kick pushes you back. So if they try to like jab punch you or something like that, I doubt they're gonna catch you, to be honest. So I've covered the pretty much the unique moves. I'm now gonna talk about jumping moves.
Yeah.
Is what move minus on block? Oh, save for that spawn of odd for the host, I appreciate it, man. Really appreciate it. Alright, we're going to talk about the jumping. Alright, so I want to get Karen to jump. I want to show you guys something. Alright, so Birdie has jumping. He has jumping light kick, which is good for like, I would say when Birdie, no, not Birdie, when Vega does that, was it flying Barcelona attack when they jump off the wall? When they do that, you can jump back and do that, or you can jump back and do jump medium punch, which is bad most of the time. But yeah, he's got that, which you can't jump in on anyone with that move. So let's say stand. You can't jump in with anyone. Yeah, see? You can't jump in on anyone with that move. Yeah, jump in light punch, which is good. And the reason why I say that's good is because you can straight do... You can do a... Or you can do... You know what I mean? You can mix it up. The hit stun is not that high. Like something like this, the hit stun's quite, you know, high, but it kind of stuns them for a bit, so you have to be careful. Alright, now we're going to talk about the jumping medium punch. Now this move is really good, really really good. The jumping medium punch crosses up, but you can also do like fake little things like make it look like it's crossing up, I'll say about here. Or you could just do empty jumps as well. People will be looking out for jumping medium punch, I assure you. So you could just do just certain things like just jump or just... That wasn't even a combo. I don't know why that never came out like that. Okay. You see what I'm saying? Like, you could just pretty much just fake jump into them. And they'll just be like, what? Why did you fake jump? Why didn't you do jump and medium punch? And what that would do, that would just psychologically mess them up. So, there's that. There's jumping medium kick as well, which is good to try and get in certain things. Sometimes it trains with a lot of anti as well. Really good to get in. Jumping medium punch is good to get in as well. Solid damage. Jumping hard kick is good to get in as well. So you can do certain things like... Same with jumping hard punch. You can do that to get in combo. Alright, so that's all covered. What more can I talk about? Lows? Alright, cool. So he's got his crouching light kick, which is good. Got crouching light punch, which is good to annoy people. You know when you're on that last bit of health and you want to try and just annoy people? Not even annoy people, just try and catch out a block. Like, so they've got, if they got low health and you're like, oh, try to cross up. They block the cross up and you're close. People can mash out light punch, Jack. I'm not going to tell people not to. Some people might put it scrubby, but it works. Crouching medium punch is amazing. So we're gonna do jump. I want to tell you guys something as well. I want to go back to the jumping stuff as well. Alright, so with Birdie, yeah, every time you can cross up. So you could cross up for like into like a... You could do a jumping like as well. But yeah, let me get into the anti air now. Alright, so Birdie anti-air is really really good. Like, most of the time it doesn't trade with like jumping hard kicks or jumping hard punch. I would say more enjoy it, that's one of the best anti-airs. So someone jumping in, you can kind of like condition them with crouch and medium punch to command grab, but if they jump again you miss, like how it happened. So what you want to do most of the time, what I would do is standing hard kick just to condition them, just to see what they're going to do. If they get hit by the hard kick, that means they like to jump. They block, it means next time when you do it, you are able to command them. Or you could do overhead, just to catch them in the air. Because sometimes you catch people in the air with overhead. Yeah, like that. Alright, so you got, so I've taught you that. Crouching medium kick is really good for a range. You know, you're there, you're trying to get to somebody. Nice. Most people will not want to press buttons too much because the range is really good. And then you've got crouching medium punch is really good as well. I mean, not crouching medium punch, crouching hard punch is really good. So it's really good finding people. If they jump, you can also cancel it with the V skill, which I'm going to tell you later on. So crouch. I want to guard this one because I want to see how much this is on block. Alright, so we're gonna do, like I said as well, I'm not, you that might be like, well, this guy doesn't know most of the frames. I don't know majority of the frames, but I know some. So I'll say jump, where is it? Crouching hard punch. Crouching hard punch is -9 on block, yeah. So this is -9 on block. I don't wanna be doing that too close. Yeah. And then, but the thing is though, is if I do get them, oh god, I can cancel into the chain. Which is really good. Or I can cancel into... So there are some good things, you know, you could do quite a lot of things. It's see certain things what they do. Can you do one arm? You can do pretty much whatever. You can do whatever. That was just to show you guys what can happen. Alright, so, and you got crouching hard kick as well. Crouching hard kick is really good. So you might want to do certain things like, let's say someone's blocking. So you could do crouching light punch, crouching light punch, standing light punch. Or crouch. So I do crouching light punch from deep, crouching light punch, two crouching light punches, one standing light punch, and sweep. That sweep is pretty much safe. If you do it at max range. So I'll do. Look at the range. Look at the range. The range is sick. One more time. So that is the range. Like, I'll say about, you know, just about here. The range is really good. But again, if you do it deep, if you do the sweep deep, how much is it? Let me see, crouching hard kick sweep. Minus 11. So it's quite bad. Freedom done really well, man. Congrats to him, man. Alright, now we're going to talk about super moves. They call them super moves? No, not super moves, special moves. Alright, cool, so stand up. Okay, so we got light punch ball head. And then we got, I don't really like talking about frames too much though. See, on here it says light punch ball head is 2. No, that's standard. Alright, cool, so I'm thinking what? Yeah, so light punch ball head. So light punch bullhead is minus 10. So is medium punch bullhead, but medium punch bullhead covers the range. And then the hard punch bullhead is only minus 5. And then you've got the EX one, which is this one here. It's really good for catching people if they're just standing. Sometimes people walk back and forth. What I usually do when people walk it back and forward is, let me show you a pattern that you might see if people. Because they're usually trying to buffer up on me. So, usually people do this. Like, whether they're trying to get into you. Cool. So now, what I usually do is I sometimes take the pattern. So I'll be like, okay, he's moved back. Once he's moved back a little bit, I'm going to be like, all right, cool. Not like that. But, you see what I'm saying? So I'll always wait for them to touch forward. Once they touch forward, I'll try and get them with the EX ball head. But again, EX ball head is not safe. It's not safe. I know people have been like, right, is that move safe? Nope, it's minus 10. Ball head. So, I mean, not even ball head, sorry. Ball horn is minus 18. Yeah, that's big damage. Minus 18. Let's get this off. I don't want to see this. So. And it's the what does it say? Airball frames, 17 to 34 frames, 50 frames of charge time. Okay, so this is minus 18, which is mad. But this is really good to get from fireballs. Really, really good to get from fireballs. And then we've got the EX one, which is minus 9. So then now you've got chain, which I don't like using chain unless like it's minus 23. The hanging chain, light kick, medium kick, they're both minus 3 on block. The hanging chain, hard kick, I'm more than sure, it doesn't say on block, but I'll say if you see me do it in the air, then I'll say it's minus 23 as well. Hanging EX chain, and EX is minus 49 frames. So yeah, you gotta be careful with the chain. The chain is not a move that you throw out just like recklessly, like you will get hard. So you've got that one, which you can do setups. So you can do setups like, to see what people are doing. Command grab. You've got the one which puts your cargo away, which you could just, I would throw a can. If I do the furthest, I don't really see Birdie players use this one. Throw a can to confuse them and then do the hard kick ball revender. And then you've got the hard kick chain, which pretty much is if you're jumping, me show you. So if you're jumping, I'll catch you. There's certain ways to kind of like catch people jumping. You could like throw a can, see if people will jump. That would be a good way, that people will jump on this can. Everyone does. Or some people will firm it. But again, like I said, I'll show you certain ways to use the V-skill. What's that for me, man? Alright, so we're going to talk about his command grab. So he has the light punch version, which is one headbutt and then another headbutt. This one is meant to be really good range. So like, that looks good. So, media punch one is second, isn't it? In terms of the main headbutts. And then the hard punch one, it has to be deep. You won't catch, you know. Light part one, you have to catch him. Hard part one, you can't catch him. Hard part one, you have to be. It's a T headbutt, and it's an headbutt, which is really good. And then you got the EX one, which is throw invincible. So if people get up and they try to throw you, or you get up and they try to throw you, you can just do this one. Which is really good. So now, what other moves do I have to show you? Ball Revenger. Okay, so Ball Revenger is really good. So Ball Revenger is the move where he jumps up and gets you. Light punch one is already good if you. The safe is up if I do like standing light kick. I could do standing light kick and then do it. So people are not gonna expect it. Or you could just do jab into it. Or medium punch into it. I don't know if you can cancel on block though, crouching one. Crouching hard punch into Ball Revenger. I'm not sure. I doubt it though. Let me just try it. This is something I've never tried before. You guys will see it first. No, it doesn't work. Oh, no, it does. Oh, snap. So instead of it being minus 9, I can cancel it into... Okay. Bro. So if I want to get out of trouble, maybe I could do... It's a bit hard though. If I were to get out of trouble, I could just do that. But people will want to punish that move. Or I could do crouching hard punch into... Maybe here? Change? Yeah. Oh, snap. I never really thought of that. But then that makes me even to even more trouble. But you can't cancel it into command grab. I know people are thinking, I'll just cancel it into command grab. No, it doesn't work. Or maybe I could do... Because if it's minus 9, yeah? I might as well do hard punch ball head because that's minus 5. So I don't get like a minus, I don't get a minus 9 punch, so I'll just do that. Yeah, I think that would be better. Yeah, thanks for that Voltro, man. So basically, I suppose, yeah, I would rather do that instead, I'll be honest. I never really thought of that. I'm gonna implement that into my gameplay. Alright, so what are we talking about now? Alright, so standing like not even starting light kick, sorry. The Ball Revenger light kick one is from close. So from a little distance you could do it. I'd say from further distance I'll do the medium kick one. And then from far away, this is like if you want to get over a few kids with Sonic Boom, certain things like that. Like roll a can, boom, the can will come with it. You're nice. Alright, so and then we got the dolphin dive, which people know me to be like the best with doing dolphin dive. So dolphin dive can be controlled. So I'm just gonna show you now. So that's the dolphin dive from here. If you press forward, you can command it to go further. But the only time which is good for here, is say for example if like Karen does, if a character does a move and you wanna punish it, say for example, because Karen does sweep a lot. Like, a lot of Karens that I know do sweep up, so... There we go. So is it on? Yeah, okay, cool. So we're gonna show you now. So that was my bad. It was fast. There we go. They're not gonna expect it. The best time to do dolphin dive is when people least expect it. Don't be doing dolphin dive when you've got a bar and it's like, oh, okay, well, yeah, I've got a bar. Let me just waste the EX. No, I never do that. The best time to do dolphin dive is when, like, I know they least expect it. They're just chilling. Chilling, they're sitting there. throw out a move, throw out like a medium kick, throw out a jab, throw out things to make them confused and be like, okay, right, what's he trying to do? Just get close to them, open back. You know what I mean? So, those are the moves. Oh yeah, an EX chain, yeah? EX chain is really good for like, catching people out when they throw like fireballs and stuff like that. And it also catches people if they try to jump as well. I didn't explain that properly. Let me explain it to you a little bit more better. So, alright, so if they jump, I can catch someone in their jump like that. So if they like, say for double without, catch them out of speed. Alright, cool. Don't jump. I call you jumping. The best thing to do is like, don't stand too close. I'd say stand a good distance before the EX chain. Because if you throw it close and you get blocked, they're gonna punish you. How do you control the space of how to do EX dolphin dive? You press forward or back. So, like I said, I'll explain it again. So, to control the space, you hold forward. So, see, I've gathered more space now. If you don't want to gather that much space, you just leave it. And the same thing, you can't press back to kind of control it either. It's just forward. If you need to go forward, so like around here, I reckon I could catch her. How much you guys bet that I could catch her from her? I feel like I can. There we go. The reason why I caught her is because I held forward. Now, if I call her, I can't catch her from there if I don't hold forward. You have to hold forward, so if I'm really feeling like I want to catch her, I will be forward. Now, the issue with this as well is that if you hold forward while you're trying to do it, you'll end up going over them. So sometimes if you're close, if you know you're close, try and do medium kick. Medium kick is the best way to find out if you're close to them. Medium kick, don't be nice. You're in range. But if you press, alright, so if you do medium kick and try to do forward, you're going to go over them. But if you just press medium kick and they blocked it, don't even hold forward. Leave it like that. So they're in range. They're in good range. Again. So that's one of the good ways of explaining how to do dolphin dive and trying to understand the range of how to do dolphin dive. So, alright, that's been explained. What are we going to explain now? Because I've explained jumps, I've explained anti-airs, crush counter combos. Alright, cool. Because this is another thing now. People always are like, rah. I want to do crush counter combos, a good crush counter combo. Alright, so we're gonna go in. Alright, so you could do... Not if you're blocking, I can't. Alright, let's take that off. Alright, so... Medium punch all the way. You could do... It could be... you could do that in the V-trip as well. Or critical R. You can also do... Other things as well, which I'm going to explain. Alright, so you could do... Can do that, but there's way more things you could do. I done that wrong. Some people, you could do that from like, because that would do more damage. It's less scaling because you ain't done more hits, so you get over half bar from just doing that. Common one that I've seen Shady do it, and when I see Shady do it in playing the online, I was like, wow, this one looks really good. So you could do dash up, and that does a lot. We need to put the attack data on because people are not gonna know. All right cool, so we're gonna do, did I do it right? So that's 6-8 stun. That is insane. 41 damage. Wait, so you could do... you could do that as well, which is really good. The damage is going to be over 50%. So that's 5-5-7 damage. So I'd say Birdie's really good against like low health characters. He really does put damage in. Another one you can have is... If you don't have V trigger, yeah, I'm trying V trigger from this. This is a common one that everyone does. That is 329 damage, 475 stun. So that's a lot. So when look at the stun, look at the stun buffer one. So if I did that again, that's stun. I'm not gonna say the likelihood of that happening in the match is unlikely, but if I did, I'm just showing you pretty much how bad. Like, the stun is really, really good. All right, so we're gonna go to, say for example, if you're in a bad situation and you don't want to do the dash into full head, you can also do hard punch. I'll punch grab that does quite a bit of stun. There's other little things like that. And we can do stuff like that as well. I don't know if I've missed any. I feel like I've missed some. Those are, oh yeah, these are V triple ones. I see V triple ones. Oh, there's another setup as well, so like, if they blocked the banana, that would have hit them, so. I'd say. Yeah, this one's really good, because look, they're not gonna jump. They're not gonna jump, they're not gonna do anything. They're gonna be like, raw, I'm trapped. Press a button, you're gonna slip over the banana. So, see, I don't wanna explain all the B-skill stuff here, because I've got so much B-skill stuff that I wanna show everyone. But, I'll explain that in a bit. Alright, let me show you this one now. So this is a V-School combo. Not a V-School combo, sorry. Critical combo. Crush counter combo. So, what was it again? Medium punch. Alright, so it's pretty much the same combo I did before. See? And that ends up on the other side. Now, with this here, I'm going to do quick get up. I'm going to show you why this is so sick. No, counter on. How do you do wake up again on this? I kind of forgot. My brain has just gone completely blank. Set wake up action. Yeah. What's that move she does again? No, it's not that. What's her wake up move again? I told her how to do it, it's going too quick. Isn't it like Dragon Punch bullshit? No. I don't know why it's coming out with that. Maybe it's not registered that she has a yes or something, I don't know. We could do that, because most people would do wake up jab. Alright, fair enough. Alright, so she's gonna wake up straight away. Why is that not on? Alright, cool, set wake up options. Okay, because off. Alright. Alright, six. Alright, we're there. Alright. But do they get up straight away? How did you quick get up? There we go, recovery. Normal recovery. Cool. I can't believe I never saw that. That is so silly. Sorry guys. Alright, so we're gonna do the combo again. Safe. That's what I'm trying to say. Quarter circle back, two punches. Oh, was it quarter circle back? Oh, safe. You guys are legends. But I thought it was Dragon Punch more than safe. I wonder why I wasn't getting it right. There we go. You guys are legends. Thank you. Thank you very much. Alright, so. Crouch in the hard part? Okay, didn't do that. Didn't do the combo there. Crouch in the hard part? What? It's not hard. I know, I'm making it seem harder than what it is. There we go. Alright, just look at the damage of what just happened there. Just look at the damage. Catching up. You have to do it mad early. crouching up. But I don't know why I'm missing this. Here we go. Stun! You're dead! You're dead! You see what I'm saying? So, there's a lot of things you gotta take into consideration, man. Alright, so, not only that, let me see something. Okay, so that will miss. If you wanna be stylish, you could do that as well. I like to do that to characters. I don't know why. I've got issues. Alright, so, that's that done. We're gonna set wake up options off. Alright, now we're gonna do another crush cut combo. I'm gonna show you, these are like more damaging crush cut combos. So we've got that one. And then you've got, not that one. Got that one as well. 65 damage. Also, you have. I didn't do that much. You got that as well. 405. There's quite a lot of damage. Yeah. Alright, so we've got past that stage. You know, I've showed you about our hard punch as well. Forward hard punch as well. Things you could do with crush counter is... Alright, hold on. Let me go to... Let me put it in the center now. Alright, so if you catch someone with a crush counter now. Immediate punch. People often see me do like standing hard punch. I don't know why. Sorry, I'll tell you. I've got a lot of tweets, man. Shout out to people that are retweeting my tweet about me sharing the birdie content as well. It's alright. Alright, so you've got forward hard punch into standing hard punch. I do that all the time. I don't know why. I shouldn't reset people like that. But the reason why I do that sometimes is because I like to do that. If you... This does the most damage from what I know. That's 237. That's 273. And that's the set 378 stun. So you could do EX squared as well. But you're not gonna get as much as what I've got from this. You're not gonna get as much. I think in the corner as well, correct me if I'm wrong, you should be able to hard kick hang No, you can't, okay. No, you can't. Alright, fair enough. I was wrong. Okay, so we've done crush counter combos. Is there anything else you guys want to learn? What's going on, Super Cali though? You good? Alright, we're going to talk about... I didn't talk about his low move, did I? I didn't finish off talking about his low move. Or did I? I didn't talk about the dolphin... this year, that dolphin slide. You guys have got to know to do it at max range, because if you do it too close, it's a minus 5. It's a minus 5, let's talk about it these games, let me know. I think it's minus 5, I'm not sure. I always got to go back to the V-frames just to find out. I'm more than sure it's minus 5. Yeah, it's minus 5. On hit, it's minus 1. But you see what happens, yeah, when I do that, this move here, if it hits, I'll do medium punch straight away. Medium punch will always counter. But, you know, theoretically, it kind of is your turn though, if I'll be honest. Minus one frame, it's not that bad. Alright, cool, so I think that's it for this lesson. In the corner, can you get in the corner you can get forward high punch into critical heart. Not even in the corner, you can do it. Yeah, you can do it like that. It's fine. I never really tend to do it though. You don't even have to wait. I think you could do it immediately. I think you could do it immediately. Oh, you miss it. No, you get it immediately. Alright, is there anything you guys want to learn? Let me know. Any matchup for specifics? Alright, cool. So, again, guys, like I said, if you guys want to see me do matchup specifics, I need you guys to tweet. Because next week, I'm going to do matchup specifics. Like today is just pretty much kind of understanding Birdie and learning like what to do with Birdie, because there's people that have always said to me, bro, how do you do this? What do you do? How did that? So instead of me just like saying it to everyone individually, I thought let me just do a video where I explain it live so everyone can kind of understand what's going on. So you guys could ask the questions with that and you guys could know what to do. So I didn't talk about V-trigger. I didn't talk about V-trigger. So I want to talk about V-trigger V-split right now. Okay, so Birdie has three different V-skills. So he has Banana, which stays there for like about 5 seconds. And then you got Can that goes pretty much, it follows you off the screen. And then you've got the Donut, which pretty much builds up bar. But all three of them build up bar, but I think the Donut builds up bar the most. So I want to take off his V-Guard. His burn bar. Got a burn bar. Alright, so as you can see now, I'm going to do Banana and shit. So there's Banana, yeah? Stays for like 5 seconds. I'm going to do Can. Can doesn't really take you that much. Now the Donut. Oh, they're the same, they look like they build up the bar the same. I've always thought the Donut builds up far more. I think they're about the same. But either way, I think the best thing to do is, if you really want to annoy people, I'll just say, eat a Donut from far. I really want to annoy people. Alright, now I've built up B-trigger. Now what I want to do is go into B-trigger. Go. That's -2. You guys do that. But what I want to explain is, let me just build up bar quickly and show you guys something. If you guys wanna do the V-trigger safe, do stand guard. Guard all. Alright, so if you guys wanna do V-trigger safe, EX all heads into V-trigger is +9. So if you guys want to do that, +9. Because of the first hit block stun. So if you guys see... Alright, let's take this off. Look at this. If you see the hit stun, look at the hit stun. See? But the only reason why I slide that is because of the hit stun of the second hit of the ball head. So that's the reason why I slide that, and that's the reason why it's +9. But you're cancelling it. I think it would be even more if V-trigger was just 0, but because it's -2, it makes it +9. So it would be like +11 if it went to 0. Did you ever use his standing animation as a projectile? No, I never used that. Never ever used that. How do you fight Shoto's? Oh, you're eagerly waiting to sub. About time. Love for that, bro. Again, like I said, so those are his V skills. Again, if you guys have any questions, let me know. I'm gonna now go into V-trigger and cover V-trigger. So again, like I said to you, the easiest way to activate is EX full head into V-trigger. Other ways to activate is the classic way of, if someone's pressing buzz and you wanna try and get through their defense, do that. And then EX full head. Take them in the corner. 5 or 8 stun, that's ridiculous. So you know, the best way to try and Alright, so the best way to try and fish out for things is crouch and meaning peek. Everyone's always got a panic button after that, because it's like, right, you're close. I need to press a button. Or maybe just do two. Just do one here, do one there, and then release the ball head. Move on, sorry. So do that. Fish out for it. You can only do that combo against the wall, but yeah. So pretty much, if they block it, I think you're like minus. I don't know what you do after that. Let me try and see. Because if you do ball head, if you do ball horn, the next ball horn is minus 9. Yeah. But I don't know, because the first and this time, so you'll be minus 11. Because V skill takes. You wouldn't be minus 11. I don't know what you are. Actually, like, I need to figure out what you are, because animation is not ending. You'll be something, I don't know. If someone can clarify, I don't know. But you're minus, you're definitely minus. I think minus. I'm not going to call out a name. I'm not going to call out a number. Yeah. Alright, cool. So, again, like I said, so I'm in B-Trigger now. I want to know what to do. Now, I think everything is up by 10%. So, his grabs do more damage. Now, his grab does 180. Yeah. Back throw does 180. His normal stuff does damage. Like, that's his jab. Look at his jab damage. Hard punch damage, crouching hard punch damage, everything has gone up. You do not want to get crush countered by a V trigger burn. You don't want to be, I'm telling you. Like, you don't want to be. If you get crush countered, every time if I just do this, look at the bar, you're dead. Look at the bar. You can't muck around with V trigger burn. It's insane. Look at that. That's insane damage. So, maybe against low health characters, you might want to just build up bar quickly with the feature, that maybe that might work. But the thing that I'm going to explain now is, when you're in V-Trigger with Birdie, any type of ball horn will deplete the bar. Ball head will deplete the bar as well, any version. So now if you want to replenish the bar, eat donuts. That's the only way to replenish the bar. So you just done. So that's the way to build it up. Banana does not build it up at all. Can doesn't build it up either. He really needs to eat donuts, so you better get him them Krispy Kreme donuts, boy. There we go. That will build up his bar. Yeah. Now, throws don't. Like Ball Revenger as well. Ball Revenger doesn't defeat his bar. Any of the grabs don't defeat his bar. The special moves. Chain doesn't defeat the bar either, because it's a grab. That's the reason why most players will classify Birdie as a grab for the character. So, again, like I said, it's cool. But one thing I want to show you as well, Birdie in V-Trigger, his EX headbutt is ridiculous for the damage. That's insane. Like, all of his stuff is so high damage, like, you don't want to get hit by it. You don't want to get hit by a crush card, so you have to be safe. That's a lot of damage. Alright, so I pretty much covered everything. These grabs as well. So if they get up, you could do sweep. And you'll be at safe range as well. Sorry, I didn't explain that. Yeah, if you do sweep, you'll be at safe range if they get up straight away. He has one of the worst grab ranges, like, in terms of like normal grabs. Apparently he has one of the worst. Again, if you do this, you could do dolphin dive, but people get up. So I'm gonna show you the mix up. Come on, grab. Dash. Come on, grab. See what I'm saying? So I could do this. If people try to jump, come on, yeah, I'll do the EX chain. So that's the mix up that you can do. Some people prefer not to get up, but I always see when people get up. So as soon as I see, I always buffer it. Always buffer it. Always. So I might even just do it and not do nothing. So that's the best way. So yeah, that's about it, man. MDZ Jimmy's hosting me. Whoa, snap. Thank you very much, MDZ Jimmy, man. I appreciate it, man. definitely, definitely appreciate it. Wow. So, shout out to everyone that's coming from MDV Jimmy's stream. What I would like to say is I'm just pretty much giving everyone a tutorial on how to use Birdie. I noticed that a lot of Birdie players like to use him, but don't know how to go the extra step, which is the issue. So I'm trying to help people learn how to use Birdie on a tournament level. And yeah, we'll just see how it goes from there, man. But yeah, shout out to MDV Jimmy for the host, man. I appreciate it, bro. Yeah, I know. I just shouted him out, man. Shout outs to everyone. Shout outs to everyone from MDV Jimmy stream. Alright, let me get back to this now of what I was saying. So, like I said, in V-Trigger, like I said, the best thing to do, look, walk speed is faster as well. It's a lot faster. You could just scare people by literally just wanting to grab them. Look at the damage on his grab. The damage on his grab is insane. You don't want to get crushed out. You don't want to get crushed out. And you don't want to receive. You definitely don't want to see EX. EX hip hop grab. Look at this stun. Like, he can really stun you very quickly. So, that's it, really. I ain't really got much more to say about that. Shout outs to Josh Terror as well. Shout out to Embrace. Shout out to everyone that's coming from MDV's Jimmy stream. Yeah, so like I was saying, in V-Trigger, don't spend your days doing this. Don't spend your days doing this. Don't spend your days doing this because you're depleting the bar for no reason. Like, the only reason why I might sometimes do it is simply because I'm gonna scare people into the corner. That's the only reason why I might do it. So I might just throw a can. Might go eat the egg, throw a can, throw it. Because they're thinking, okay, they see a can, they want to get at him, they want to jump, you know what I mean? Look, if I throw a can now, and you see me dash towards you, you're going to want to grab. I mean, you'll want to either jump up, or do something that goes over the can. Also, one more thing as well, that I want to show you guys. In EX, I mean, not even EX, sorry. One sec. When he's got a V-Trigger, he has armors in some of his moves, so... On Light Punch Bullhead, he has armor frames of 3 to 7. Like... Shout out Shay, make sure you follow the stream as well, bro. Appreciate it. So, yeah, on V-Trigger... Let me just put my picture there as well, because this is moving a bit mad. Just trying to explain everything and make sure that everything's clear to everyone. Oh gosh, it says I've got that many. Okay, cool. Alright, so again, like I said, let me explain this a little bit more clearer now. Alright, so on V-Trigger, I want Cameron to do a move. What's a hard hitting move? She does hard punch. Okay, cool. So we're gonna do hard punch. So, you meant to have armor. See that? That's the armor. I never knew that he had armor on. That's insane. I didn't know he had armor from that. I thought he had armor from his hard punch one. So I learned something new. He has armor on that one as well. And he has armor on this one. Is really, really good place. You can activate pretty much. Go close to somebody. Close enough. There we go. But the reason why this one's sick as well is because the amount of hits. And then you can just confirm the wow, it's so sick. Again now, like I said. How fast is Cameron's light kick? It's quite fast, isn't it? So, let's do a light kick. We'll light kick here. Alright, we're gonna mash that out. Just working them legs, alright. Now, Birdie's EX Bullhorn is 2 hits. That's what you guys know. That's two. The EX one is 2 years. I'd rather do like, let me change characters. I want to show you guys properly. I don't want to just do it and not show you guys practically how it works. I want to show you guys exactly how this thing works. Exactly how it works. Alright, so we're going to do Underground Arena. We'll do Birdie. We'll do Right. Right's got a 2-hit fireball. Shout out to everyone that's in the stream as well. 109 people. Shout out to Spawn of Odd. And shout out to MDZ Jimmy for the host as well. I appreciate it both. Definitely appreciate it. Alright, so I didn't really want to do this one today, but I might just do it, you know. I might just do it. Alright, cool. So Ryu, you have a 2-hit EX fireball move. Alright. Cool. So now you've shown me that move. I wanna, for example. So if I see him, 2-hit. 2-hit. Alright, cool. Quick, gain your bar, King. Oh yeah, I'm not in EX, alright. Cool. I've caught him pretty much throwing 2 hits. If I see the EX fireball, I'm gonna do it. Alright, so EX chain takes up 2 fireballs. It destroys it. It's like, what are you doing? Alright, now does that do it in normal? Let's see if it does it in normal. Yeah, it does. It does it in normal. So for example, if you give me the fireball and give me, see? It's serious stuff. But you gotta know, like, what. Sometimes in the distance, they might think, yeah, it's good to do EX fireball, but I will catch your EX fireball. This is the problem. You can also dive under fireballs. Remember what I told you earlier on as well? I told you that Birdie is projectile invincible on a certain part of his golfing dive. I'm going to explain that in another video properly so you guys can understand the timing of the golf tonight. Really good, really, really good. Alright, so, yeah, so as I was saying, let's stop that, right? I don't want no more fireballs thrown at me. Alright, so, EX1 does 2 hits, which is really good. We need Ryu to do a move because I want to show you that his Bullhorn as well has 1 hit of armor. This is why Birdie and V-Trigger is really, really dangerous. Really, really dangerous. His offense goes through the roof. So we're going to do medium punch. Just medium punch. Okay. Oh yeah, we didn't say it. Okay. Let's see. Trying to get him to do it to me. Every time you ask, I'm gonna beat him. There we go, 2 hits. That's 1 hit, sorry. So what happens is that I could possibly do, let's say for example I wanted to mix it up. Why is that? Why am I not with that one? Saying like V trigger Birdies did the same, very very insane. So now Mandigomon, thank you very much for the follow, I appreciate it. So now I didn't explain the can setups to you guys. Oh my days. Should I, if you guys want me to explain the can setups, press 1 in the stream chat. If you lot don't want me to, then I'll do it next time and just go straight into lobby. Let me know if you guys want me to, so I can do it. Okay, I've got some serious can setups and banana cells. Alright. I want to see one more thing with Guile as well. I want to see if EX chain goes through all of these sonic booms. Oh, you guys want to see it? Yeah. All right, cool. I'll show you guys. Let me just find out something with Guile. Shout out to Guy with no eyebrows. Gamer Verb, thank you very much. Again, like I said, if you guys are following the stream, shout out to you for supporting. If you guys are not following the stream yet, please do support. Alright, I'm gonna show you guys the setup. I just wanna see something with Guy's EX Sonic Booms. So we're gonna get into it. Alright, cool, we're gonna get into it. Let's do it. So I didn't turn it on, did I? Whoops, no, let me turn it on. Okay. Oh snap! I did not know. But that does take a lot of power. Alright, so let me see what it does in Birdie goes in the V-trigger. Okay, cool. Do your thing. Look how much free hit shit. Okay, I'm mucking it up because of the problem. That's interesting, you know. That's quite interesting. So if I'm third here, yeah, if I'm close enough here, yeah. See, I knew it. If I'm close enough, madness. You see what you guys have just read, what you guys have just learned, and what I just learned myself. I did not know that could go through all of that. Oh my gosh. See? There's stuff with Birdie. Birdie's a very unique character, but people just don't, they haven't exploited him. You have to exploit him really well. Okay, cool. So, yeah, alright, sorry. You guys want to see concepts. Alright, cool. Alright. I'll show you the very basic ones. All right, so with Birdie, yeah, people, like I said to you before, Birdie gets scared of hands. I mean, other players get scared of hands. You can do stuff like that. The turning one is if you throw a can. I'm gonna show you the basic ones, and I'm gonna go into the very intermediate ones. So, what am I looking at? All right, sorry. So I want Guile to jump. So Guile's gonna jump. I'll throw a can because I know that it's gonna scare people into jumping on it or blocking. So if they jump, if I see that jump, I'm going to catch you. Now if you crouch, some people will be like, right, you know what, blatant, I will crouch and not do anything. All right, cool, bro, safe. A dolphin died. You know what I mean? Like there's so much other things as well. You could just dash up, overhead. But you know, you have to stand up for the overhead. By the time people might not even recognize that I'm gonna do it. So if it's for the first like only, say if it's on Fadu, yeah, you're gonna get hit. Cause remember there's 8 frame lag as well. So what we're gonna do now is show you the more harder stuff. No, there's one more actually, there's one more. Alright, so press sweep somebody, press counter. You're not gonna press buttons because bananas there. No point, you might be able to do flash kick, but yeah, I doubt people will, because the banana's this close to you, so you gotta watch out. Alright, so we're gonna do the difficult stuff now. So we're going to do the more difficult stuff now. Like I said, if you guys appreciate what's going on and what I'm doing, please just support by pressing that follow button to build up the channel. I'd appreciate it. Okay, so we're going to do stand stuff. Alright, so remember I told you about that V-trigger combo? I'm now going to implement it into what's going on right now, so... So now, what happened there is, if he doesn't get up straight away, which I'm going to show you the combo now, no recovery. So, some people won't get up because they'll expect me to do this combo. They'll expect me to do that combo, right? So people are not going to get up straight away. Now, if you don't get up straight away, that's what happens. So it's a cross-up, it's actively a cross-up. So I'll do it again so you guys can see. See, it's a cross-up because you wake up and you face the other way. But it's really hitting you from behind. You have to block it the other way. So do you see what I'm saying? It's a bit crazy, but you know, it is what it is. The other ones we have is, I showed you guys pretty much when I was doing the stuff before, but I'm gonna show you again. Just so you guys know. Hold up. You gotta do crouch and hop hunt immediately as soon as you land, and land on the other side of them. Now, the only issue with this is that you're really close, so you have to take a risk. Because they might do an invincible wake up move, or they might just stand there and try to grab. So it really is a bit, if they try to grab, you could do the EX grab because it's throwing invincible, but you can just stand there and see what they're going to do, or maybe meet them with like a hard kick or something. So yeah, there's always that. I'm going to show you another setup as well. Veggie done it apparently yesterday. I've not tried it out, but I'm going to try this one. So maybe like if I dash out, let me try it out. Yeah, okay, so that's the setup. Dash. I didn't do it right, my bad. Sorry guys. This is a new setup. So. Again, there's that setup as well, which is really good. So we have quite a lot of setups, man. We have quite a lot of things that are going on right now. There are other things as well. There are a lot of other things. So we have to look at like... It usually starts from this. It usually starts from this. This is where it usually starts from. And then come on, crap. Look at the stun. Dolphin dive, maybe. Dead. This is what I'm saying. It's so mad. It's so mad. But yeah, what we're going to do is we're going to leave it there for today. And for the next, I would say, should we do a battle lounge? Should I do a battle lounge? My notifications ain't off. They're on, ain't it? Oh, it is off. I don't know what's going on. Yeah. I need to test my notifications. Two seconds. I don't know what's going on. Oh, no. It's not off. Oh, okay. No, play ranked. Okay. Let me play ranked then. I don't really want to play ranked, I'll be honest. Ranked is pit of hate right now, but we'll do ranked. Everyone wants to see me do ranked.